Yo, 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 welcome back to my channel. It's Big Dirty. Yeah, yeah, that's right, Big Dirty. How you guys doing today? I'm doing so well, thank you so much for asking. All right, you guys, so apparently there's some beef with Ariel Helwani and Brendan Schaub. I ain't gonna hold you. I don't really understand what's going on. Hopefully this will explain it to me. If it doesn't, I guess maybe one of you can. I don't know what's going on. I heard something about Brendan Schaub made a remark about Ariel, and then Ariel made a remark about him or went off about him, and it's just been back and forth. Anyway, two of them, I personally find them extremely annoying, so this is kind of interesting that they didn't combine forces and actually became friends to be, like, ultra annoying together. It's just the world we live in, I guess. Okay, enjoy!
About talking. When you're thinking about thinking, are you guys following? Brendan Schaub, Ariel Helwani. I don't know where these two can't get it right. How are they in this back and forth?
The beef begins.
I see Ariel's there.
Yeah.
How's that going over?
And I'm here.
No. But how's that?
How do you think he got the job?
But how's that going over?
I didn't
want
to do it.
Yeah.
But how's that going over?
I didn't want to do it.
The twins are here. The two thumbs, you guys. Joe Rogan and Dana White.
I've been sitting back for the past 18 months, and I've seen a lot of people take shots at Helwani. Well, guess what? I'm punching back. An individual named Brendan Schaub, who was lying constantly about me. You said that you got the job first from Showtime, and I only got it because you turned it down.
Round two.
I've never personally worked with Ariel, ever. He's the closest thing we have to Stephen A. Smith, right?
Best way that he was going to be able to win was use his wrestling.
Right.
Try to take him down.
The only thing I've heard about Ariel, and I've heard it from a million people, does not play well with others.
Yeah.
Anybody I know who's ever worked with him does not have nice things to say.
Knife things.
Anybody I've ever talked to in the MMA space says do not work with him.
Shots fired.
He's sitting back in his little chair. I've heard from a million different people that this guy is the worst to work with. He is the worst colleague on the planet.
I don't know about you guys, but in this shot, it kind of looks like his head. Right? Am I just seeing things? Like, it looks like his head is kind of edited to look bigger than the rest of his body. Maybe it's just the camera. I don't know. I digress, you guys. My bad. I just couldn't focus because it looks so weird. I don't know.
I have heard this from all... Who are your sources, Brendan? Who are your sources? You don't sit around and talk about someone's character like that. That's not how this works.
Yeah.
You smeared my name publicly.
Yeah.
Lied about me publicly. So I want you to go...
Dude, Ariel is such a snake. I love how he's, like, trying to talk about character. Like, you don't talk about someone's character like that. Boy, please.
On your public little show, and I want you to apologize to me. And so once he does, the beef will be squashed.
The apology.
But then you have time to think about it, and you feel a little bad.
I feel bad.
Now,
you're referring to Ariel Helwani.
I might be referring to Ariel Helwani.
I saw you on Monday. I go, I made a mistake. I have no issue with Ariel.
I know.
Him working at Showtime has nothing to do with me. We don't even do the same job.
Yeah, I know.
So I made it seem like the only reason he was there is because I turned it down. That's not the way it went down.
Yeah.
And I apologize for it. I texted him, apologize for it. He wrote me this novel. There's obviously some underlying other issues that he has issues with.
With you mean? Or?
In general. You know, if you're a sensitive guy, that's what it is.
So it sounds like he just wants to have dialogue.
You know, I don't know. That's not what I do.
I know a lot of you now want to hear my take on Brendan's segment about me yesterday, I think it was. I knew he was never going to apologize. Of course I knew he wasn't going to come back and be as sincere as he was on this text on camera. He can't do that. And so the funniest thing about the whole thing is I'm watching this segment. He doesn't even bring it up. His boy Brian brings it up, who continued to say, Ariel's so sensitive, Ariel's so sensitive, Ariel's so sensitive.
Ariel's a very sensitive
Maybe
guy.
Maybe you'll see tonight.
Yeah, he's very sensitive.
Well, okay.
Ariel's too sensitive for that.
Yeah.
But he's sensitive.
Oh, okay.
Some people are.
What makes you think I'm so sensitive? Is it because I'm annoyed that for the past like 5-6 years, you guys keep saying these lies about me and I've never even responded once?
The UFC 199 rumor.
UFC 199, he leaked the Brock Lesnar news and got his credentials pulled and banned from the UFC.
Oh!
That was Dana, right? Because Dana got
that
mad about
Dana.
It.
That was Dana. That was the UFC. You got to remember, at UFC 199, what was the UFC trying to do with UFC 200 announced Brock Lesnar? Sell the company.
Yeah.
Right.
They're trying to get evaluated for the maximum, you know, whatever, $4 billion.
Yes.
And them having Brock Lesnar was going to do that. So by him stealing their shine, releasing it, it's a business. That's why Dana was like, you're out of here.
The UFC 199 thing continues to be retold in a 100% inaccurate way.
You know, the reason why the UFC doesn't like Ariel is because he was told backstage that Brock Lesnar was coming back and that there'll be an announcement. And then he went and wrote it up.
That never happened. Brendan is sitting there 5 years later after I've addressed this a gazillion times.
So,
you know, he made his bed.
did that happen, you guys? I actually don't know. Now that I know Dana had like not had stopped allowing him to come to the press conferences and stuff, but I don't know if that was the reason why. Possibly it could be. I don't know. Who knows? Possibly. I don't think it's not like it's out of the realm of possibility. You know what I mean? My thing is, it's like, why, if it's bothering Ariel so much, then why didn't he say something sooner? Like, if this has been going on for 6 years, I mean, everyone has been sort of taking shots on Ariel because he's honestly, he's really annoying. I don't know about you guys. If you don't find him annoying, that's awesome. But he like really digs in a way that's like really frustrating. The way he poses questions, he tries to stir the pot. You know what I mean? So I'm like, why are you offended by this? You could just say that Brendan Schaub was doing the same thing you do. He's just stirring the pot. You just happen to be the subject. Like, you know what I mean? I don't know. I'm not a journalist. Thank God. I don't do this job. But I just think that they're more similar than anything, you know?
And he has to line it. I got it just like anyone gets any story, sources, hand to God. I had no idea there was going to be an announcement that night. I didn't know when they were going to announce it. You know how many times I've been told things off the record? You know how many times I've been told things in the vault? You can't repeat this. If I would have broken that trust once in my career, I'm done. Nothing is bigger than breaking someone's trust. Like, you would never do that.
Unless one of them drops it, it will be a fight. Brendan and Arrow will be fighting. I don't take a joy in that. I'm not here to promote it. But I will be covering it.
Whose side are you on? Arrow's or Brendan's? Comment down below.
Neither. They're both annoying. Yeah, he's like, I'm not here to cover it. Or no, to promote it. You know what I mean? And then he's like, I'm just going to cover it. Whose side are you on? I don't. They're both for me. I'm just like, I can't stand Brendan Schaub. Ariel Helwani is like really snakish. And I don't like the way he does his journalism. But yeah, let me know what you think. Who do you think? Do you think we have it wrong, you guys? Do you think, hey, Ariel Helwani is a misunderstood professional? He did his job well. Everyone's just going in on him because they're racist. Or do you think like, oh, I'm kidding, you guys. Please don't go in those like freaking comments and be like, they're not racist, blah, blah, blah. I know, I'm making a joke. Everybody calm down. Or do you think, you know, Brendan Schaub is misunderstood and he does have his own personality and he does think for himself and he doesn't just ride off of Joe Rogan's little fame of a little clout, you know? Let me know what you think. All right, you guys, thank you so much for joining. Give me a thumbs up, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.